Hey guys, Hello Bella here. In this video, I'm going to be telling you about my 50-mile challenge that I completed in August. This was something that I wanted to do, and me and my best friend actually wound up doing this together, and it really built a really sustainable habit and practice. I want to tell you guys about it so that you might be able to come up with your own challenge, or you might want to do this challenge. So this is the page that I use for my challenge. It's a really simple printable, and it's just 50 circles, and I filled in the circles as I ran them with a highlighter, and I've actually written in Sharpie the miles each time that I was walking or running a mile. I didn't run most of these. I actually walked most of these because I'm not really a good runner, and walking for weight loss is just as effective. I like monthly challenges because I can use it to commit to something to help me on my weight loss journey, but also it kind of propels me forward and gives me that motivation that I need to not give up, to not be a quitter. So we averaged about 1.6 miles a day of walking, and that's about what it takes to do the 50-mile challenge. Days where I only did like a half a mile and 1 mile, and then there were other days where I felt more motivated and I did 3 miles. So it wasn't the same amount of miles every single day, and there were even some days that I just didn't do any miles at all. I think walking for weight loss is really great because you don't have to have a gym membership and you don't have to have any kind of special tools. You don't have to buy anything. You can literally just put on your shoes and your clothes and take off. You don't have to be anywhere specific. You can walk in the woods or in the city. So I think walking is like really the ultimate like weight loss tool because it's so simple and it's really good for your mind and your body to really just get out there and move. Doing a walk in the morning is a really good way to start the tone for the day, and as well as doing a walk in the evening really calms my nerves. I have a lot of anxiety, and so I feel like after a long day, if I can just go on a quick walk, I feel like 100 times better. I think the two things that really helped me keep up this habit were, number one, having my accountability partner, which is my best friend, because she would text me sometimes. She'd be like, I'm going to walk, do you want to come? And I'd be like, oh my god, no, but I will go. And there's other times where I would text her and I'm like, come on, we need to get these miles today, we got to do this, and she would reluctantly go. So having an accountability partner in any aspect of life really is super, super helpful. I kind of got to the point where I would be really, you know, motivated at some days and she would be motivated at other days. So we really were able to help each other along. The second reason was that I am, like I said, a super type A person, and I love checking off the circles or filling in the circles every day. And just anytime that I get to check something off a to-do list, it makes me really happy. The biggest problem that I have right now is trying to figure out a workout and a food plan that makes sense for me. And the consistency thing has been for me to just work out 30 minutes a day. And that could be anything. That could be walking, that could be cardio, that could be lifting weights. But as long as I work out 30 minutes a day, I don't want to beat up on myself because, you know, that's a consistent habit and that's something that I can keep up for a lifetime, essentially. So my current weight loss is really centered around calories in, calories out. So just counting the number of calories that I consume every day for like a slow and steady maintenance type of weight loss. Like, I don't want to lose too much weight too fast. I've really been averaging losing about 1.5 to 2 pounds a month right now. And I feel like that's good for me because I don't have to be too restrictive in my diet. I don't follow any type of eating protocols. I don't do low carb or keto or anything like that, and I don't have anything against that. It's just that I don't want to have to give up entire groups of food or things or categories of things to have to, you know, think about that for the rest of my life. I feel like it's much more sustainable for me to just be mindful in my eating and somewhat intuitive. I mean, there are days when I feel like I need to eat more protein, and there are other days like I'm just really snacky and I don't really want to eat a whole meal. I just want to snack on stuff. So I try to listen to my body and give it the respect that it needs. And that's something that I wasn't really good at in the past. I would really beat up on myself and binge and things like that, and then exercise obsessively. So this challenge has really helped me get grounded in the fact that this is about building a sustainable habit. It's not about doing 50 miles in 2 days. It's about doing 50 miles over the course of 30 days in order to, you know, create something that is more meaningful and more long-term. In the last 2 months, I've lost 4 pounds, which I didn't really feel like was very much. And I guess it isn't very much in the grand scheme of things, but I also calculated that it was like 2.1% of myself. So like, yeah, 2% of me is just gone. And it's kind of funny to think about how we lose parts of ourselves and gain parts of ourselves. But just, you know, from calorie restriction and working out, I feel like that has been really sustainable because I've still continued to go out to eat and drink alcohol, definitely more than I probably should, but I'm still seeing consistent weight loss just by creating these like foundational habits. I read a lot of self-help books, and one of the main proponents of them that they keep saying over and over again is to get 1% better every single day, or to just improve every single day. And I think that's true. If you can try to get a little bit better every day, you don't have to focus so much on overcoming this massive obstacle. You can just kind of focus on steadily beating yourself, almost like you're playing a game against yourself. And that's really true, because when I started this challenge, it was kind of difficult mentally for me to go walk, and I had to sort of get into the mindset of, okay, this is just something that we're going to do. It's not going to be, you know, necessarily something that you love to do every day, but eventually it's going to get to the point where you don't think about it. And that's kind of how it became, because the other day I caught myself and I was finishing a walk, and I was thinking about, wow, I just went to go walk and I didn't have a challenge. I'm just doing this because I want to do this. And that's when I realized, like, the 50 mile challenge, like, seeped into me. And it's kind of funny, because it's just a silly sheet, right? Like, it doesn't really mean anything, but in another way it does, because it's allowed me to create a new habit. And new habits are really hard. New habits are difficult to maintain, and we have all this motivation in the beginning when we start something. And I know this is very true for me, because whenever I start something new, I'm like gung-ho about it. I'm like, we are going to do this. We are going to give this all of our effort, and we're going to buy all this stuff to go along with it and do this and dive deep into this. And then, like, a week or two later, I just kind of forget about it. And I have a very, like, obsessive personality, so I'm sure that comes out a lot on this channel. When I gained weight, I didn't gain weight overnight. I gained weight over 5 years. So I feel like, in a way, this challenge is really helping me see that, like, okay, progress is slow, but consistency is key, because I was consistently eating too many calories for 5 years, and now I've got to consistently not eat too many calories in order to reverse the damage that I've done. And I don't want to beat myself up on it, but I just want to be aware of it, that, like, okay, this is something that happened. It doesn't have to continue. And I feel like in a way we're either getting better or we're getting worse. And so this challenge helped me in a way to get better. I'm going to leave a link to the PDF so you guys can use this and do your own challenge. There's also some 100 mile challenges that people are doing. Actually, for September, I'm doing a squat challenge. So I'm doing 100 squats a day. And that has really been hard on my back and on my legs, but I've been doing it, I think, for 10 days straight now. So I'm really proud of myself, and I hope that you guys got something out of this video. I am really trying to bring new content to the channel, and I know that some of it won't always resonate with all of you, but if you enjoyed this and you're thinking about doing your own 50 mile challenge or 30 mile challenge or 100 mile challenge, please leave a comment below and tell us about your challenge, because I get really excited when I hear other people talking about things like this. And I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and whatever you do, just remember that consistency is really key here, and it's okay to start small. It's okay to have a small habit every day. It's actually much better to have something small every single day than to undertake some giant endeavor. So with that being said, I will leave you guys with what I always say, which is have a great week, and I will catch you in the next video.